We know the bad news about Parnell. We know that Valverde is probably going to be the guy, at least for now. Let's start with him. Certainly his velocity was up the other day. What did Jim Leland tell you about him, though, when he got here?
Well, I tell you what he told me, Kevin. He said, listen, don't believe all you hear about the split finger. He said he got outs with his fastball. He said when he locates his fastball, he gets outs. Because what you do is when he's pounding the strike zone with his fastball, guys chase the fastball, and then looks like he gets easy outs with the split. But he said where he gets in trouble is when he's falling behind with his fastball, which I thought was great advice. The one thing he told me is, Terry, you will never know the difference in this guy from if he struck out the side the night before or if he gave up two runs the night before. Same guy every day, which I think is going to be huge for some of our young pitchers to see.
How experimental are you going to get with that eighth inning, in games that you have a lead? Do you have an idea where you're going to go now, or are you really going to kind of throw stuff against the wall and see what sticks?
Well, we did bring up Kyle Farnsworth, who's done it.
Yep.
He's not only pitched the eighth, he's pitched the ninth. So right now he might be the guy we look at right away. But I think we've got to make sure that we realize that we've got to have somebody ready for perhaps a big left-handed hitter, that's going to could come into the mix. So, but I just think you got to, to just sit back right now and to name he's the guy. I don't know if I'm ready to do that just yet. So we'll work, mix and match as we go. But right now, I would have to say tonight, if it's the eighth inning, because we know we throw strikes. That's one thing about Kyle.
Josh Sattin in there against the lefty Gonzalez tonight. I know you said you might get Duda in there tomorrow. I know you're not going to do that every day, though. You're not going to rotate a different guy every day. How are you planning to let this play out in terms of how long will you go before you decide, all right, maybe I'll give more of the at-bats to Ike or Duda or something like that?
Well, Kevin, we're going to do it real soon. I mean, one of the things we have to do is we've got to make up our mind here and give one of these guys the opportunity to see what they can do. And if they don't rise to the occasion, the other guy will be in the lineup. So that's going to happen very, very soon. I just thought, we brushed Josh Sattin here for the exact purpose of today, and that is to face some left-handed pitchers and play first base. So, but as far as the other two go, we've got to pick one of those guys and give them some consistent at-bats and see what we got.
I know it's only one game, but going off the history of last year, 18 strikeouts the other day, does that number bother you, and is there a way to get better on that? Obviously, you led the league in that department last year.
Well, it does bother me a little bit the other day. Now, we did face some pretty good,
right.
Strasburg's very, very good.
Sure.
But, what we've got to do, Kevin, with two strikes, we've got to back off the fact we think we have, to hit a homer. And let's cut the swings down. Let's let the ball get a little deeper, and let's put it in play. Let's take a single, because a lot of times two or three singles can add up. So, that's one of those areas that we've talked about in spring training endlessly. But we do have some guys who are, power guys, and they swing the bat hard, and they're going to strike out. So, you've got to sometimes, realize that there's going to be days like the other day where, we had the lead, but yet we still had way too many strikeouts.
Clearly, rewarding Juan Lagares for a good day the other day. What did you like the most about what he did at the plate?
Well, the first at bat was really the one I liked the best. The base hit to right field. It was a very, very good at bat by him. Stayed with it. Didn't get too big. Took the single. I thought all of his at-bats were pretty good. So, coming in today, we don't have a lot of guys that hit Gio very good. So I was going to put some right-hand hitters in there, EY does not hit him very well at all. So I just said, I got to get CY. He feels good. I want to get him in there tonight. And so just came down to putting Juan back in center.